Welcome back to Sunrise Daily. Well, yes, we'll come back to the consumer matter. It's your day, so we need to allow you to share your experience. But in the meantime, you could keep tweeting at us because we'll come back to that in a moment. But for now, let's turn our attention back to the back and forth with the customs. So joined this morning by Ismail Bello, who is the Deputy General Secretary of Textile Union Workers of the NLC. He's also the former State Secretary of the NLC. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Well, the NLC was strong on this, as a matter of fact. They also did say that that policy was not a good one. It should be shelved. But what informed their decision, even though at the moment customs has said, okay, well, let's put this on hold. But what were the underlying reasons why Labour took to their guns?
Yeah, first was that the policy was retroactive. It concerned vehicles that were not just newly bought, but vehicles that were previously bought in the years in the past. And we also feel that at this critical period, you know, to empower the customs again to join other forces to begin to check vehicles, particulars and customs duty on the road is going to bring a lot of hardship on very ordinary people. And we also reckon that it is not the end user that pays duties. It is those who import these vehicles that pay duties. So if things were to go normally, these duties ought to have been paid by those who imported those vehicles. So to pass the burden again to end users who are already in very difficult situation, given the kind of the economy that we have, we felt that it is not a policy that is well thought out at this material time.
But it's a verification process that the customs wants to carry out. Are you not in support of it?
You are not going to do verification on the road. I mean, the policy says, I mean, given the way the policy is put forward, is that it empowers the custom people to stop people on the road. I was traveling to you, but I was stopped on the way. Where is your custom duty? I'm not an importer of a vehicle. I bought the vehicle. The vehicle ought to have duties ought to have been paid for those vehicles. So we believe that if government wants to do a reform, that reform has to be a total reform.
What would you suggest that the custom do?
First, at the point of entry, I'll give an instance. Sometimes in 2001, when there was a big problem of influx of textile into the country, other imported goods, the Obasanjo administration came up with 100% port inspection, other destination inspection, they said. And it was a little problematic, but it yielded result in terms of curtailing inflows of smuggled goods. And so we needed to have been consistent with our policies, not that you go forward, you go backward, and then you make the end users to become victims of policy inconsistencies. So the NLC is not opposed to duty collection, because we know government must generate revenue. They were opposed to a situation where the burden of government policies will be passed on ordinary citizens.
But the way it is now that the customs have said, well, let's ensure that this is on hold at the moment, so we're not going to proceed with it. What if at the end of the day, they go back to Senate and eventually decide that, look, we've identified reasons why we think that we should bring this back? Would Labour perhaps, seeing the reasons, change their stance?
No, it's clear. We are saying that it is normal to collect duties on items. But what in the immediate, what we are opposed to is the retroactive effect of that policy. If you want to you need to have a policy template that looks at the immediate challenges and how to solve them going forward for the future.
But you know, these checks happen because you said once upon a time you were on the road, you were stopped.
Recently.
Wasn't that part of that particular policy? Is it because they came up and announced this one and said, no, we're given a month window for people to comply? Is that why you thought that this is a new policy?
No. They said so. They are even talking of vehicles 2015 backwards, and that if people needed to go to certain offices to regularize this. Our take is that if you start these cumbersome processes, it's also going to inflict a lot of pain of people who have bought their vehicles a year, two, three, four backwards. If you want to start a new policy, why don't you have a takeoff point, explain the policies to people, and people then understand the way you are going. When it has a retroactive effect, the tendency, as we know with our security agencies, is that they are empowered to inflict pain on very ordinary people on the road, wherever. So that's what we are saying, that at this material time, maybe the customs and government itself needs to come up with clear-cut policies going forward, not to talk of a retroactive policy with regards to duty payment.
So if need be, what you're saying is, let me get it straight, you can start from today and go into the future.
Yeah, exactly.
And then other cars that don't have duty, that are already in the system, let them be.
Not necessarily. If there are specific issues that they want to deal with, or specific importers, or specific people that they are targeting, that's a different matter. But it's not going to be an wholesale, free-for-all, so number of vehicles. That means in the past, something is completely wrong with the administration of customs, with the structures of customs. And we saw that with the illegal import of firearms. How did they leave the port? Why intercept firearms on the road? So those are the critical issues that we think government should deal with. Restructure the customs in such a manner. We are in an era of technology. People should know what goods are coming, what it is supposed to be paid, where is it coming from, where is it going to. Not that when it gets into the society, see the chaos that happened in Sangwata the other day, overrise market. The mayhem, the killing, the brutalization of very ordinary people. We are not saying they shouldn't. It's good for the economy that they protect the border, but we say that they should empower the customs in terms of capacity, they should empower the customs in terms of deployment of technology to be able to enforce government policies, not to enforce it in a manner that brutalizes
All right.
the people.
Let's go over to Mark Boy for her questions.